Don't get overexcited. It's just a robbery.
Okay.
To Algonquin Dukes Expressway, please. You're speaking my language now.
Liberty City Gun Club. Liquor, guns, and fun.
Oh my God, she had blood all over her legs. The car was totaled. And she's sitting there, and she's still drinking. This chick used to be a celebrity.
Oh my God, he's so high. He'll never make it on stage.
You just can't help getting sucked in on the way down. The number one rated reality show is coming back for another season. Playing with the Stars, the show where we follow formerly big celebrities on their way down. Five contestants, one fading dream, a ton of alcohol and drug abuse. Waning with the Stars is the ultimate reality show. Because like in reality, everyone likes you. Then you turn into a depressed, drug-addled mess. Enjoy watching once smug celebrities who've hit rock bottom. Stay there. Waning with the Stars, a new season coming soon on Diesel.
If everyone gets road rage, then it's not really abnormal.
Maybe they feel sorry for
cracking doofus, Laszlo, only on Integrity.
All right, you're listening to The Laszlo Show, only on Integrity. We're broadcasting live from the streets of Liberty City. Nobody does live radio anymore. Nobody, apart from me. I'm your host, Laszlo. It's been a long time, Liberty City. Too long for both of us. Kind of had a dry spell there, you know? Liberty City's like a woman, you know? You love her, you hate her, you come...
Here we are.
The chicks in Liberty City have higher expectations than the slobs in Vice City.
Whoa.
Ah, Nico, good to see you.
You too. How are you, Mr. Gravelli?
Good. I was just speaking to our mutual friend about you. He said how efficient you were. I like that. Then he mentioned something about a Darko Brevich.
What? He did?
Yeah. He's located the guy. It seems he wasn't in Switzerland at all, but in Bucharest. He'll be here soon.
Good.
And it seems your Russian friends are getting the message. Some of them.
Oh, okay. So...
I think it's our turn to do a favor for that mutual friend of ours. Seems some Korean has come into the country and is selling money at a discount. You don't need me to tell you that it's all fugazi. Faker than a pair of vinewood tits.
That's good.
Listen, I need you to deal with this. Eliminate the guy. What he's doing is no good for the economy. And no good for patriots like you and me.
Huh. So who is he?
His name is Kim Young-guk. He'll be very well protected. He eats at Mr. Fook. Fuck.
Mr. Gravelli, are you all right?
Yeah. I'm fine. Wait, what was I saying?
Kim Young-guk, he eats at...
Yeah, right. He eats at a restaurant called Mr. Fook's Rice Box. Yeah, in Alderney City.
Don't worry, I'll take care of it.
Okay, we're going to Linden Avenue.
No problem, I live for this shit.
Life is
is a challenge. And if you could swallow a magic pill every day and not worry about that challenge, wouldn't you? We all would. Some of us are. Take, for instance, our best-selling symptomatic postural tension reliever, Comanex. Life is stressful. Up the dose. And with increased dosage, people will see an inverse reduction in problems. It's science, really.
Life is stressful, and the reason it's stressful is that the consumer is forced to pay pharmaceutical companies like yours exorbitant fees to cover these prescriptions and CEO bonuses. HMOs like mine are trying to save your life, and Little Miss Drug Company here sashays into the doctor's office, flashes her perky bazookas, and the next thing you know, the doctor's prescribing heavy sedatives for every splinter or rash. And who gets to pay for this? The insurance companies, which we are obliged to mark up and pass on to you in denied coverage claims. It breaks my
heart. This is my last job, man. Big party tonight.
Man, it's making our immune systems weak. My mom was a visionary and a helper, you know, and she left me in dirty diapers all day. And now I have a super goddamn immune system. I can let the floor under a truck stop urinal, and it don't affect me a bit. And sometimes I do, for cash or whatever.
That's the problem. Let's stop blaming the HMOs because you can't see a doctor. Don't blame Nixon because you've got bad coverage. Bottom line, don't blame me because you're a loser. Not my fault, buddy. And the last thing we need on Earth is socialized medicine. Jeesh. Can you imagine the chaos if everyone was able to see a doctor and didn't have to fill out reams of paperwork before they were denied a life-saving surgery because it cost money? It would be anarchy. There'd be lines for bread, and we'd all be speaking Russian or Cuban, and people would
That's
die.
A fresh paint job, man. Dying
because of paperwork and lack of coverage and their failure to understand the small print.
Okay, Lennon, I understand. You want to live in a socialist utopia. Fair enough. Well, I don't. I want choices. I want access. I want... I've got it.
Here we
you
are, man. End of the line.
Paid more attention in school, you little shit. Then me
was Where is Kim?
He's upstairs, speaking with the manager. They don't want to see nobody, though.
Kim and I are old friends.
Kim got a lot of money. He don't need no friends. Get lost!
You have to come out now! There's nowhere to run!
Having
fun!
I've
got it in my sight!
You're glad you matched with me?
Aye! He's going down!
This is it!
Where is Kim?
Kim's not here. He left a long time.
If you play stupid, you're not going to live very long. Where's Kim?
He heard you come. He ran out back through the kitchen.
You're going down, asshole! There's no way out, motherfucker!
Thank you. thick.
Try this on for size. It's been fun, but the party's over.
He's passed his last false bill, Mr. Gravelli.
Well done, my boy. This is gonna be a fruitful partnership for us both.
Where to?
So, we're going to Mahesh Avenue, got it?
Okay, hold on then, Daredevil.
Great, thanks.